Yes, indeed, that is true. Our new adventure, our new adventure, our new creation, and indeed, our life, will probably not last very long. That's true. And I've come to terms with that. In fact, I have viewed it as perhaps a significant and perhaps even enjoyable challenge. And let me also just remind you that the same thing, as we go forward, is probably true for you too. Your business, your venture, your career, indeed your life, will probably not last very long. I don't think that's morbid. I don't think that's meant to depress you. I think it's meant to encourage you to live fully right now and to live well. And so, let's take a few minutes to talk about that and perhaps for you to respond to just that. I'm Stan Houston. The Creator Entrepreneur is on the air.
Space, a final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its five-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
Donald Trump. You've heard the name. President Donald Trump yesterday returned from the hospital because he is now infected with and suffering from the COVID crisis. He's gone through it. They think his prognosis is really good and that he will survive and he'll make it through. But as we all know, but we try to forget, is the prognosis for all of us is the same. As I say, and my brother and doctor friend say together, if we're fortunate enough to grow old, we will get sick, we will get feeble, we will lose our style, our weight, and much that we have. And then we will die. That's right. If we're fortunate enough to grow old, we eventually will get sick and feeble, and then we will die. Hopefully that progression does not take years and years and years. Or as one of my dear friends said, I want to just go right away. And that's exactly what happened. He was working hard, enjoying life, and after dinner he sat down in his favorite chair, picked up a book, and he died. Right there. Right then. And of course, those of us who know him said, in effect, that was a blessing for him, because a long, prolonged illness would certainly have gone poorly for Eugene. He would not have liked that and would not have probably handled it very well. Probably a grace thing happened to him even in his death. Well, now we're at 6 minutes and I want to bring that into our life and business as a result of the COVID crisis today. Now, many businesses are going to go out of business. They will not make it. And I think it's very clear to those of us who are watching that almost every business is going to have to significantly change the way it works. And that's not going to be easy for many people. It's hard to make those changes. I also make all of that very personal. Now, we're starting to take the creator entrepreneur as a new avenue, new venture from a previous incarnation. We've changed it into the Creator Entrepreneur Institute, and it's going to be a teaching and studying and promoting and perhaps a coaching company. And we hope to help you become a world-class creator entrepreneur. But we've also, because of our many years since I've been doing broadcasting, the next anniversary will be almost a half century of broadcasting, and I've certainly loved radio for every bit of that long, if not longer. And we are starting What It Takes Radio as a full podcast radio station. Now, you see, you can do that because now you don't have to have a tower, you don't have to have a transmitter, you don't have to have studios. All of that million-dollar stuff that you need to have a radio station. As someone once said, my friend in the radio business, those towers, perhaps I can get a good price for the scrap metal. That transmitter, well, it's probably, maybe I can sell it to a museum. Because the radio business is changing. And internet, on-demand, audio, radio will be the future. And we think we can help you and your business make it in that future. And What It Takes Radio will have 3, maybe 4 basic channels. First of all, the Creator Entrepreneur, where we have you and many others giving advice and counsel and stories and strategies on how to make it in the marketplace in the post-COVID 21st century. Because we love it, we are also going to have a channel called The Cowboy Spirit USA, and that is going to be so much fun. We are going to have a variety of people who have radio programs about the West, about cowboys, about all of that Western tradition and Western lifestyle, which literally there are millions and millions of people who live and enjoy and look forward to a very special radio program for that. So it'll be the Cowboy Spirit channel. We're also going to have one called The Master's Voice. And this will be primarily for my friends who want to take the Christian, the gospel message, the lifestyle of Jesus and the beliefs and practices. So churches, ministries, organizations, even businesses that want to make sure they're going to fly that banner with incredible and increased intensity, which is very good, because please keep in mind, in the new reality, it's not just what you got that people can buy. They will buy on what you believe. That's right. They're not only just going to buy what you got, they're going to buy what you believe. And so that will be part of what we do. And we'll see where it goes from there. I would like to have songs and stories, a whole channel of people from all around the world who are in their second half of life, who will use the opportunity to share their wisdom, their tragedies, their triumphs, their stars, their scars, and they will tell their stories. And they'll share those stories with others and perhaps leave a little bit of a audio legacy for their children. So it's called Songs and Stories of Life. Now, those are the 4 channels that we're hoping to fill with people like you. But here's what is true. That business will not last very long. It's not going to be around for 50 years, 100. The ages of businesses being around and passed on to first, second, third, and fourth generations, that time is over. businesses are going to seek a good run. 3 years, 5 years, 7 years. By that time, it's going to have to change significantly, or it's going to have to shut down quickly and do something different. Businesses, and I'm very clear about this, What It Takes Radio is something I will love, I will nurture, I will give my effort to, even at this stage in my life. Michelangelo did his best work between 75 and 89, and we're going to give it everything we've got. But it won't last very long. Did you know that? And let me tell you, the same thing is true of your business and your career. It's not going to last very long. And neither are you and I. And we'll talk about that as we finish up. Great predecessor in my career, you know, the ultimate coach was a man named Warren Buffett, who was the coach and counselor to all of the top business stars through much of the 60s, 70s, and 80s, well into the 90s, even in his older age and stage, late 80s and 90s, he was still active in the business. But one of the things he said that he discovered that after a while, he realized that he could not help a business go and grow unless the leader of the business could answer this one question. How do you want to be remembered? How do you want to be remembered? You're going to leave. You're going to be gone. You're going to die. How do you want people to remember you? And Warren Buffett said that he realized that unless a man, of course, it was mostly men at those times, but unless a man or a woman could answer that question, he couldn't help them. Another Peter Kostenbaum, a great business philosopher, said that unless a man or a woman knows what they want to achieve and how they want to be remembered, it's not worth getting up and going to work in the morning. You need to have that power, you need to have that knowledge, you need to have that creativity, that spirit within you. Now let's face it. None of us are going to be here very long. Life is very short. Even when it's long, it's short. One of my hobbies is to make pens. I love to because I want to be a maker, because I've been a messenger and everything. I love to make things. And so I take scrap wood and scrap countertops, and I've got some abilities now through doing some woodworking and having a little shop that I can actually make a very beautiful pen. It probably is worth a lot of money compared to those New York City pen shops. And I oftentimes give them away. That's what I do. I love to give pens away. And I have a little line that says, life is too short to go through it writing with an ugly pen, so write beautifully. And by the way, what will happen is that when my daughters go through my stuff, 90% of it for sure they will throw away. I have asked them at least to look at some of my stuff in the files and see if there's anything unpublished that still might be worthwhile. And somewhat reluctantly, my daughter promised that, okay, Dad, I'll look through it. But I also know that that stack of pens, that will be sorted out, and they will be given away, and they will say things like this, hey, would you like a nice pen? My dad made this. And that may be it. Some memories, something I made, and perhaps, I don't know. I have an RCA microphone. It's almost as old as I am, but not quite. But it's beautiful, it's wonderful, it's an antique, and it still works. It probably is worth more as a collecting item than it is as an actual artifact of real radio today. But I use the term RCA to mean relationships, character, and achievements. How do you want to be remembered? Relationships, character, and achievements. Because life is short. And it won't last long. And that's why principle number two is vital to you and me. Principle number two in the Creator Entrepreneur Code says we are not human beings who can have a spiritual experience. We are spiritual beings who are having a human experience. Enjoy it. Do well. Seek to build and do better things. Make the world a little bit better because you were here. But remember, life is difficult, life is hard, and life is short. So remember to live as good and as powerfully and as free as you can. And death will come, but don't be afraid. I'm Stan Houston. This is the Creator Entrepreneur. We're done for today, but we'll give you a sign off and we'll be right back. That's right. Life is short. Your business will not last very long. And then I'm just going to repeat the song that I played last Sunday night from Kitty Callan. Because your business will not last very long and your life will be short, remember that in the time you work and in the time you have, that indeed little things mean a lot. I'm Stan. Bye for now.
Blow me a kiss from across the room. Say I look nice when I'm not. Touch my hair as you pass my chair. Little things mean a lot. Give me your arm as we cross the street. Call me at 6 on the dot. A line a day when you're far away. Little things mean a lot. Don't have to buy me diamonds and pearls, champagne, tables or such. I never cared much for diamonds and pearls, 'cause honestly, honey, they just cost money. Give me your hand when I've lost the way. Give me a shoulder to cry on. Whether the day is bright or gray, give me your heart to rely on. Send me the warmth of a secret smile to show me you haven't forgot. For always and ever, now and forever, little things mean a lot. Whether the day is bright or gray, give me your heart to rely on. Send me the warmth of a secret smile to show me you haven't forgot. but that always and ever, now and forever, little things.